your flexibility, grab your yoga mat. We're going to walk you through three beginner stretches to improve flexibility, mobility, and work your way up to a split. Hey guys, I am joined today by my assistant Brianna.
Hi, Brianna.
So we are going to be doing three stretches for flexibility. I don't want to talk too much in this intro because I really want to get right to it for anyone who's watching this.
Yeah, me too.
To guide through it, but really quick, I am very inflexible. I always
awesome.
To bring someone
let's
else
get going.
More up and not let them in. Just start in a runner stretch. So you'll sit right forward and then you can untuck the back toes and slide that left knee back as far as feels comfortable for you. Then what you want to do is find a position for your hands that's comfortable. You can tap the fingers if that feels good, or if you want to put the flat down, that works too. But the idea here is that, one, we're not contracting our muscles yet, so we want to be as relaxed as possible, and we don't want to warm up. That's why we're going right into it. So just find a place that feels comfortable, and then you want to kind of rest into it. So you can kind of actually let your shoulders rest. Let your head drop down.
Can you, I remember you told me before the video why we don't want to warm up before this one. I thought that was really interesting.
So you don't want to warm up because once you start to actually engage your muscles, the blood flow goes to your muscles. But we want to apply stress to the tendons and ligaments so that we can improve flexibility. So the idea is instead of like going into these postures and engaging, we want to get into the posture and just rest into it. So then that's why we hold it longer as well, because it kind of gets your body out of that like defensive mode and you actually start to relax.
For anyone else who's a beginner doing this, like I feel super like, how am I ever going to do a split? Because this hurts me so much. It's like so tight right here. So I just want you to know, like, I'm with you. For anyone else, it's like I literally can't go any further. I look like I'd be flexible, but I'm not. It hurts, right? It's supposed to be a little uncomfortable.
Yeah, so you want to, on a scale of like 1 to 10, with 10 being you're in pain, you want to find like a 5 where you're like,
okay,
you feel it, but you're not in pain, because of course if you're going to sit in something for 3 to 5 minutes, you don't want to be like killing yourself.
Right.
Gently come out of it however you came into it.
Okay, find like a tabletop.
If you want to maybe just shake it out a little bit, you can do some cat cow. So like inhale with your head, arch your back also, and then exhale around the spine, drop your head. You can do that like a few times.
The release feels so good, right?
Yeah.
Like it hurts so much, but then it feels so good and you're like, oh, I'm so glad I did that.
So now we'll just go on to the other side. And again, you can inch that right knee back as far as feels comfortable, but you want to find that like 5 out of 10.
Got it.
So, and then again, you can rest into it. We set a timer.
So we're gonna do 2 minutes on this side too?
Yes. And you can drop your head, just let it. And then same thing here. Just try to square your legs.
Side, of course, right.
But it's just a good reminder, and it always helps when someone, not that we always have someone here to adjust us, but it always helps.
Just like the lightest touch, and you're like,
yeah.
Oh yeah.
You're like, wow.
Feels so good. Is it weird, like in yoga class, does everyone always want the teacher to come adjust them?
Oh, 100%. Like
touch
when
me.
I hear them walking,
touch
me. Saying like, please pick me, please pick me.
Don't look at me.
And the cool thing about like these poses is it might seem like if you see this pose, you might be like, oh, that's not that hard.
So easy!
But by sitting into it, like you're releasing a lot of the, like, we have emotional blockages, we have like stress that we store in our body. And so when you get into that safe place of like your body's relaxed, but it's also engaged, that's when you can release a lot of that.
Wow.
Yeah.
I know this is going to sound maybe like a little woo-woo, but like I swear I feel things in my body being released right now.
Yeah,
have you ever had that?
Yes.
I don't know if anyone else, when you're just relaxed, it's almost like blood flow and like energy being released.
Yeah, well, a lot of times, like when you're stressed out, right, there's cortisol being released or like toxins in the air, or those things like have to go somewhere. And if you're not getting rid of them, like people say, they get stored in your fascial webs and then it starts to kind of harden, which makes us tight. So, and actually, it dehydrates the fascia. So aside from just drinking water every day, which is super important, we also need to actually move our body to get that liquid to flow.
That's like rolling too, right?
Yeah, exactly.
Like foam rolling it, so it like actually hydrates your muscles.
Yeah. Oh.
Oh, there's my cue. Oh, okay.
So maybe if you want to just take a few more cat-cows on the side just to... You could even like... Fascial like is organized chaos, so it likes spontaneous movement. So sometimes I'll do something different, like in a cat-cow.
Yeah.
So you move your body the same way. So when you move it in a way that you never have before, you're hydrating different areas of your body.
Interesting. All right, so wiggle it out.
Yeah.
To the next one.
So you can come onto your back for this one.
Okay.
And we're going to do like a half happy baby, so you can kind of just focus on one side at a time. So you can, we'll lift the right knee and then also. So how does that, you can also let this foot splay out.
I don't know if it's tight from the last one, but it definitely hurts a little.
If you want for this knee, you can put like a pillow there. How does that feel?
Great.
And for this knee, we can put a pillow here to kind of pull out.
I was like, beginner over here. Like, he doesn't hit it.
No, this is all good though. How does that feel? We don't have real like yoga bolsters.
This
but
is good. This actually helps.
Just to provide the cushions, you can actually relax into it because again, we're not engaging the muscles here.
Yep. So 2 minutes on each side of this too.
Yeah. And just also something important, like don't forget to breathe. I feel like it's so easy when you feel pain, like you have it, you're holding your breath and you're contracting, like just kind of try to enjoy it.
Enjoy it. Is it weird that my arm is kind of sore?
Well, you know what? Because you're trying to pull your leg down and you're not there yet where you can pull it further, so your arm is completely extended right now.
Right.
But what you could do if you want to make it more comfortable, you can grab your big toe. Does that give you a little more?
That gives release in my arm. If anyone else's arm hurt, that actually really helped me. Because if you're so tight, you can't even bring your knee down.
Yeah.
This helped more. Now I feel a little more relaxed.
Sometimes it's easy to forget, like, because I've been practicing yoga so long, so I forget, like, what might be difficult. You know what I mean? Or, like,
that's like me.
Hyperextend or something.
That's like me when I'm sometimes sharing something about like health or food, and I'm like, well, that's common knowledge, but it's not just because my field, so it's common knowledge.
Right. Well, we say that all the time. Yeah. Like Portland will be like, what's that? I'm like, you don't know what you don't think outside is.
Does this like? Do certain ligaments or certain muscles, like, is this all kind of hip-related, emotion-related?
Yeah, well, this is because you're, like, externally rotating the hip. This is a hip opener. Mm-hmm. So, I think it's funny, like, I don't know exactly why they say emotion is stored in your hips, but I know that, like, with gravity, right, everything settles down. Mm-hmm. So the base chakras are, like, the most dense, so to speak.
Makes sense.
So... If you're not like getting rid of the emotion, the stress, the things that build up, then
by the way, I definitely
the hip
when
feels
I
a lot
to,
more
like the toes, I felt
loose.
Relaxed.
Oh, that's good.
You know,
nice.
Like I felt like I could sit
and the other side.
And for you, like so, and for anyone watching, like if that's what you need to do to get to like a 5 rather than maybe around like an 8 or something like that.
Exactly.
Okay. So I can set you up.
Big toe.
This is like the best thing to do with like a friend, and you can take turns like setting each other up with props.
Right? You set timer? actually, for me, feels better.
Okay.
Not as tight, more comfortable.
Yeah, it feels in the one side that feels mm-hmm. better than the other. And even, like, if you find a posture that feels really good, like, you can practice any type of, like, breathing technique or, like, a mini meditation. It'll take you, like, out of that, like,
mm-hmm.
you won't feel the sensation as much.
I have to think, like, having the conversation right now just takes me out of it a little bit,
mm-hmm.
and it's not so focused. This is so yin yoga, good old siren, is like holding the long poses. I know, so this is technically kind of a type of yoga, right?
Yeah, it's just, so yin yoga has like a certain set of postures, and I'm not necessarily trained in yin yoga. I've done like smaller like workshops on it, but I like to apply the principles of yin, which is like to find that 5 out of 10, to like kind of find your edge but not go too far, and to hold it for a long time.
Yep.
So those principles are what I'm using to kind of guide you right now, and I think that's kind of what's most important to like get you to a place of being more flexible. And yin yoga is great. I just
memorize
the like the step postures.
It makes sense though, because like every pose, every like twist and turn is like boosting circulation or like hydrating your ligaments, your muscles.
Right.
Like that, right? It's just cool. People think it's easy.
They're like, oh, it's so gentle, but like what it's stretching the tendons, the ligaments, which you never really get to, because usually like we're always doing warm up.
Alright, last pose. Okay, legs straight up.
Yep. And then we're gonna put a strap around the sole of your foot.
Oh, I feel that.
Yeah. So you don't have to kill yourself. Just you want to feel sensation, not pain.
Mm-hmm.
And if you don't have a strap, you can always, like, you can grab your thigh, or even if that's not accessible to you, just lift your leg in the air and kind of see how that feels.
Okay. So this is more for support. And you could use any kind of rope, I feel like, for this. Anything
sure
to support
you.
You
could even, like wrap a towel up.
Yeah.
And then, so there's tons of things you can use to make this work. Or if you are more flexible and you can extend further, you're welcome to grab anywhere on your leg that feels comfortable. Like we were kind of getting into before about yin yoga, that's great for increasing flexibility by stretching the tendons and ligaments. Whereas this posture, I actually just remember it feels perfect.
My leg's shaking. I don't know if anyone else's leg is shaking.
And props are just great because they bring the floor to you. You're still doing the pose just like as efficiently. But this posture actually is resonant of a split, right? You're doing a split, but on your back.
Mm-hmm.
If you think about it, if your leg, let's just say,
a partial split
all the way
right
to your face, that would be a split, but the other way.
Mm-hmm.
So doing resonant poses is another great way to practice a posture that you want to get your body used to it. So her body's understanding how to get into the pose, even though you're not necessarily in a full split.
Yep. And then should I, if I like kind of challenge myself and pull the leg back?
Yes, but not to the point that you're like causing pain, because you can injure yourself that way.
Okay.
But a little bit of like pull is good.
Because I actually feel, even though I'm shaking, what's weird, I don't know, like my leg's shaking, but it doesn't hurt really.
Okay.
It's just like a weird reaction.
The only thing that could be concerning about that is that like sometimes we could be causing an injury without knowing it, and it might hurt later.
Interesting.
So just a little bit of engagement, and with this posture, which I'll we'll get into it now.
Mm-hmm.
Awesome. With this posture, you want to make sure you actually are engaging your quads.
Meaning like squeeze my quad?
Yeah.
Okay.
And that will also protect you against injury. Sometimes we just yank. or body parts. That's where the tattoos come to hurt.
And when you flex your foot, you can feel it much more too.
How does that feel for you?
Good. Like it's weird. Like the first pose for me is so uncomfortable. This one, I can obviously there's discomfort, but it's like in a better way. Mm-hmm. I'm like in a, maybe because I'm laying down. The other one's just
well, this so side is better for you with the other pose.
True.
Pose in that one side that's more difficult, so to speak. But
so how long should we be doing here? So basically, for me and every other beginner watching this, we're gonna work our way up to 3 to 5 minutes. It's an everyday thing. 3 days a week. What do you think?
I mean, ideally.
Perfect practice makes good or worse. Bad practice makes bad.
I also feel like, as you know, I've had a lot of gut health issues and like bloat that's been so unexplained, and I'm really trying more understanding now that it's more of an energy block and energy release that I need. And I think that because so much emotion is held in our hips, this could even be a good like mental, not mental, but like full body practice for me every day.
I think that, I mean, being more flexible, like, aside from, like, the excitement of getting it's just good for you.
Exactly. Thank you for saying that, because the most important thing in anything I like to share is that it's good for you. Like, we're not eating healthy because we want to be super skinny. We're eating healthy because it's good for your body and it's going to make you live a longer, healthier life. Like, mm-hmm. flexibility makes you feel better, you move better, it's better for you.
Fuck okay, yeah.
So three.
I hope you guys went along and did that. We can just chat for a few minutes now. I really wanted to like on my new
They did both sides and I only did one. That's why it was so long. What?
When you flex your foot, you can feel it much more too.
How does that feel for you?
Good. Like it's weird. Like the first pose for me is so uncomfortable. This one, I can obviously there's discomfort, but it's like in a better way. Mm-hmm. I'm like in a, maybe because I'm laying down. The other one's just.
Well, this side is better for you with the other pose.
True.
Pose in that one side that's more difficult.
So how long should we be doing here? So basically, for me and every other beginner watching this, we're gonna work our way up to 3 to 5 minutes. This is an everyday thing, 3 days a week. What do you think?
I mean, ideally, like practice makes perfect, right? So doing it every day would be ideal, but doing it 3 to 5 times a week or whatever's realistic for you works too, you know? But
I also feel like, as you know, I've had a lot of gut health issues and like bloat that's been so unexplained, and I'm really trying more understanding now that it's more of an energy block and energy release that I need. And I think that because so much emotion is held in our hips, this could even be a good like mental, not mental, but like full body practice for me every day.
Yeah, you know, for sure. I think that, I mean, being more flexible, like aside from like the excitement of getting split,
mm-hmm.
it's just good for you.
Exactly. Thank you for saying that, because the most important thing in anything I like to share is that it's good for you. Like, we're not eating healthy because we want to be super skinny. We're eating healthy because it's good for your body and it's going to make you live a longer, healthier life. Like, flexibility makes you feel better, you move better, it's better for you.
Exactly.
Okay, so you're 3.
Ooh.
I hope you guys went along and did that. We can just chat for a few minutes now. I really wanted to like, you know, on my new website that I launched, I was so big on recipes, making sure that when you go to a recipe,
thanks you,
you go
guys.
Right to the recipe, then you read. Because
I really like that
like
video.
Having to scroll.
Today.
Jesus.
sticky back.